Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Nasrin Padasalai. In today's video, we are going to discuss about GATE Life Sciences 2021. I hope the exam was completed on February 13, 2021 in morning session, and many people has attempted this GATE Life Sciences paper. And also in this video, we are going to discuss the answer key for various questions, and I'll be discussing the answer key and telling you which is the correct answer. And also we are going to discuss whether the question paper is easy as what the students are saying, or whether the cutoff will go high or not. And this Life Sciences is that this life sciences is having 5 papers like zoology, botany, biochemistry, microbiology and food technology, and chemistry is a compulsory paper in GATE Life Sciences. And many people who took zoology found them as very easiest kind of thing, and botany is very much difficult this time. So this GATE Life Sciences is an important paper, and nearly lakhs and lakhs of people will apply for this GATE Life Sciences. Whereas when you compare GATE Life Sciences, the number of people who are taking GATE Biotech is very much reduced. Like only 10,000 to 15,000 people will take GATE Biotechnology. And I had also analyzed the question paper, and I had placed the answer key for various questions for GATE Biotechnology in my previous video. If you didn't watch, then please click the i card above and please watch. So GATE Excel paper is connected in two sessions. Chemistry is compulsory and it is asked for 15 marks. And other session, or candidate had to choose any two subjects from the option. So you can select two options. You have an option of seeing every question paper, and from the 5, you need to pick out two options. Okay. So and a session having a 60 mark, and 30 marks will be coming from one subject, and another 30 marks will be coming from two subjects. I hope you all know about it. And to this time we are going to see what is there. So let's get started. So first question is that which of the following does not absorb as 280 nanometer at 1 mg per ml concentration. So we all know only the amino acid tryptophan, that is TRPW, and tyrosine TRY, and to lesser extent cysteine, will contribute significantly to the peptide or a protein absorbance at 280 nanometer. Okay, and phenylalanine, that is F, which is mentioned above, absorb only at lower wavelength, that is 240 to 265 nanometer. So you all know in the option they had given phenylalanine, and the correct option is that option number C, which is phenylalanine. And I don't know whether this particular question is multiple select question or not, where you need to select multiple options. And if that, then definitely this ATP and polydeoxyguanidine will be selected. Because although we are measuring A260 by 280 ratio, but they are not having an intrinsic absorbance at this 280 nanometer. So this correct option is phenylalanine, which absorb at 240 to 265 nanometer. Where in hepatocytes are drug metabolites. So you all know Golgi is not a correct option, nuclei is not a correct option. So you might confuse whether it is left endoplasmic reticulum or smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So many students will be saying it is a rough endoplasmic reticulum, but the option is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So an overload of a liver cell with a numerous lipid soluble drugs, okay, thereby increasing a drug metabolizing enzyme in the endoplasmic reticulum. And also smooth membrane in the hepatocyte. Hepatocytes are nothing but they are the liver cells. Okay, and also smooth endoplasmic reticulum having all kind of enzymes to metabolize this particular drugs. Okay, smooth membrane in the hepatocyte, it is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, with result that all lipid soluble component will react with to this cytochrome P450 or oxidize more rapidly. Therefore, this cytochrome P450 oxidase is present on the membrane of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So the correct answer is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. To which of the base can ionosine pair up with in the oval position? It's the simplest question, and if you know about oval bases, then you will definitely answer. So this is how, and you all know about oval bases. And you all over here see in tRNA, ionosine can base pair with cytosine, D9 and uracil. So the correct answer is D9, uracil and cytosine. And definitely it must be in multiple select question. Okay. So the correct option you need to select uracil, D9 and cytosine. Next thing is that which lipid is a non-anionic? It means the lipid should be a cationic lipid or it should be a non-ionic, means it should have no ions in it. Okay, so first we can study lecithin, which is called as phosphatidyl choline, as bitter ionic over wide range of pH because of the presence of quaternary ammonium group and phosphate group. They have a positive charged group and a negative charged group. Hence, this lectin is a bitter ionic. Hence, it is a non-anionic lipid. You must know it is an anionic, not an ionic. Okay. So, lectin is a non-ionic and the option is A. We can check with the other option. An anionic phospholipid or your phosphatidyl inositol phosphates and phosphatidyl serine, phosphatidic acid, sphingomyelin and galactosidase. So the correct option is option number A. So left sheet in hemoglobin oxygen saturation point indicates. So if you know this particular graph alone, you can give a correct option for it. And if this particular oxygen saturation point is very important from CSIR exam point of view and DBT exam point of view, so consider this as a graph and left sheet indicates increased affinity to oxygen and right sheet indicates reduced affinity to oxygen. Okay, and decrease in temperature and decrease in 2,3 dispersed glycerate and decrease in hydrogen ion concentration, which implies increase in pH. The pH is increased, then hydrogen ion is decreased. Since pH is called as negative logarithm of H plus concentration, this will lead to left shift. That is, they will increase the affinity, RBC affinity to oxygen. Whereas right shift means reduced affinity and increase in temperature and increase in 2,3 dispersed glycerate and increase in hydrogen ion concentration and decrease in pH will lead to right shift. So they are asking left shift. So high pH, correct one. High 2,3 BPG is wrong. High CO2 is wrong and decrease in cooperativity is wrong. So the correct option is option number A. So, which of the following are high energy component? Okay, so you must know what is mean by high energy component and what are the groups of high energy component. High energy component means your pyrophosphate, that is ATP, enol phosphate like enol phosphate, acyl phosphate like acetyl-CoA, thiol phosphate and guanidophosphate or phosphogen is your high energy component. And that scale 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, which is an enol phosphate, it's a high energy component, and phosphoenol pyruvate, which is an acyl phosphate, is also a high energy component, whereas your AMP is not a high energy component, and vitamin A, vitamin K is also not a high energy component. And your pyrophosphate, which is an ATP, and 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, your phosphoenol pyruvate, is the high energy component. So the correct option is option number A and option number B, which is a multiple select question. So you should select both options, only then you will get a correct option. So this is an easiest thing asked in immunology field. So match the correct option. I think everyone will giving a correct options only. IgE is involved in allergies. IgA protects the mucosal lining. And IgM, it will impart an immunity to fetus. And IgG is secreted first during the primary immune response. So this is a correct option. Next thing is that this enzyme is used in PCR and it is a highly confusing question asked in Gate Life Sciences, where they have given option for primase, stacked DNA polymerase, clinofragment and DNA pol2. Okay, so you should know, in contrast to cellular DNA replication, which amplified all of the cell's DNA during the replication phase. Okay, the role of this in vivo DNA replication is that it will all amplify all DNA in your S phase. But PCR is the same technique, but they will do targeted amplification and they will try to replicate only a segment of DNA that is bounded by 2'. Okay, that is determined by DNA polymerase. And first question is the DNA primase. DNA primase is used only in vivo DNA replication. And it is a type of RNA polymerase. And the role is that it will catalyze the synthesis of short RNA segment, which is nothing but our primer. So this is a wrong option. Next thing is the tagged DNA polymerase. And tagged DNA polymerase is a correct option. As you all know, in that higher temperature, only this Thermus aquaticus DNA can able to resist a kind of thing, and also it has other application which we will discuss in our another video. So the correct option is tagged DNA polymerase. And let me tell you whether clinofragment, what is the role. Clinofragment is nothing but it is when we enzymatically clear this DNA polymerase 1 with substituting, this clinofragment will be get as a large fragment. And this clinofragment is not used in PCR, it is used to sequence a DNA, and it is used by Sanguine dye deoxy method. So the correct option is here tagged DNA polymerase and not a DNA pol 2. So which mode of transport requires ATP? And this is a highly easy but highly confusing. First option is that active transport. Active transport means you will move the substance against a concentration gradient from an area of low concentration to area of high concentration. It is just like climbing a mountain. Okay, so definitely is active because it uses an energy, which is opposite to passive transport, which doesn't use an energy. So option number A, active transport, is correct. Option and next option is facilitated diffusion. Facilitated diffusion means it is a passive movement of molecule across a cell membrane via aid of your membrane protein, and it is utilized by molecules that are unable to freely cross the phospholipid bilayer, like a large polar molecule anion. So this facilitated diffusion does not require ATP. So this option is wrong. Unaided diffusion, simple diffusion, it's again it doesn't ATP, it is a passive diffusion kind of thing. Fourth thing is that Na plus K plus 1. And Na plus K plus ATPase enzyme is an active transport, and for every ATP molecule that a pump uses, 3 sodium ion will be exported out and 2 potassium ion will be imported. Hence, this Na plus K plus pump utilizes ATP. So the correct option is option number A and option number B. Okay. So which enzyme carry out the substrate level phosphorylation? Substrate level phosphorylation is a metabolism reaction that results in a production of ATP and GTP by transfer of phosphate group from a substrate used in a metabolism pathway directly to ADP to form ATP and GDP to form GTP. And the correct option is that your pyruvate kinase, because phosphoglycerate kinase and pyruvate kinase are the two important substrate level phosphorylation reaction, and both are involved in the process of glycolysis. So the correct option is your pyruvate kinase thing, which will convert the phosphoenol pyruvate to form pyruvate, and the phosphate group from this PEP will be transferred to this ADP to form a pyruvate. So the correct option is option number C. And hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase is absent in, I all know this is a very important enzyme, and it is function primarily to salvage purine from degraded DNA and to introduce into purine synthetic pathway. And this HEPRT gene is absent in this myeloid cell, which is a cancerous cell. If you studied hybridoma technology, then definitely you will know myeloma cell is HEPRT minus, whereas your B cell, T cell, macrophage need this HEPRT for their survival. These are normal cells, hence they should renew, and this HEPRT is required. So the correct option is your myeloid cell. And which column is used in gel filtration chromatography? And it is a type of size filtration chromatography which separate a molecule based on size. And this this DEAE is a positively charged resin, and it is generally used in an ion exchange chromatography. And the cellulose CM is not used, sephiroth is also not used. Cepadex is used in gel filtration chromatography, and the correct option is your dextrin blue. And this blue is used, it is generally too large and it cannot able to get into the beads, and therefore excluded. And it is generally used to determine the void volume in gel filtration chromatography. So this dextrin blue is a correct option, and apart from it, Cepadex is the most commonly used. Next question is that now the simplest question from blood typing. Anti-B antibodies are found in the serum of patient. See, this is an antibody. Anti-B is found in the serum of patient A. So the correct option is A. If you know this particular thing alone, you will definitely know this answer. So that's all for this today's video. If you found them useful, then please click the subscription button, and more videos I will be upload once the official answer key will be released, which is will be released on February 18. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you didn't click the subscription button, please click the subscription button below. And thanks.